Hello, and welcome back to another episode of MudRunner. I apologize for my frustrations in the last episode, but this hill is just a troll. Anyways, we're past that. We got a whole new set of problems. We got one more map after this, and it's the toughest map of all. And I would like to get on, so that could start on it at some point. So we're gonna try and get this finished up this episode. That's what I say. Alright. We're gonna need that fuel with us. So we're gonna be hauling a little convoy. Oh, I love the convoys in this game. Just because, you can do them in a variety of ways. Make it, challenging or interesting, or efficiency, if you're going for that. That's always an option too. Right? So, this game offers like a lot of variety in that sense, I think. Let's see. Yeah. That's crazy, man. That's it. Pull a little bit closer. Too close though. Alright, let's go. We need to get back out to the road there. And then we can actually get another convoy going, which will take us around this blockade, right? And we'll be able to reach our destination of the lumber mill up there. So yeah, it's a pretty direct route. We just gotta get the trucks around the blockade. Alright, let's go, buddy. Gonna keep this big old beast here in one low the whole time just so we can power through all this mud as quick as possible. Because we're pulling a fuel trailer and that truck behind us too, right? So we gotta keep that in mind. And it doesn't matter if we use like almost 50 liters a minute. We got a fuel trailer hooked up to the back. So it's no big deal. And if I do sniffle a little bit throughout this video, or this episode, guys, I'm sorry. It's still super cold here in Canada. And by God, it's just terrible. Some of you, who live here in this part of the world will know that. Others, if you haven't experienced the winter or the cold, you're lucky. Just consider yourself lucky, that's all I can say. But onwards with the video. So yeah, we're on a nice little pace here. Oh my god, my neck, I don't know. I literally, every time I start this game up, I could have my PS4 running and whatever. I come in, as soon as I start up this application, this game, same thing every time. Makes me wonder why. Okay, how's he doing back there? Looks like he's doing okay. As we go slow and steady and we make sure to cut the turns wide. That's it. Oh, how's that guy looking back there? Alright, let's continue. Yeah, that was very interesting though, that hill climb. Like I said, I'm a very determined individual when it comes to challenging the game. I'm gonna have to practice and get back to you guys on that one in the challenge series. Like I said, I'm still trying to figure out how I'm gonna do this transport challenge. Thinking I'm doing. It'll be interesting nonetheless if I can get it to work. If not, I'll have to rethink it. Which is no big deal. No big deal at all. Oh my heavens, you got a bit of a lean on there, buddy. Where are we going here? Straight across here, I guess. drag him through any more crazy obstacles here. Oh, sorry. That's it. Come on, D535. You can do it. I believe in you. If you save these two trucks from the hill, you can get them through this, no problem. Because, yeah, that truck behind us, he's going to be the lead truck for, whoa, for our next convoy we're going to get going. And that's going to be interesting. Alright, so far so good, though. That's what I like to see. Let's see if we can get it going a little bit quicker from here. You know, I didn't even notice that. That's how good the D535 is. I thought it was, yeah. Awesome. Now we're rocking. That's it. Get up here. And then we can detach from him and drive him forward. That's it. Just a little further. Okay. So we're gonna move this truck up here so we can refuel them both. Nope. Just over here off to the side of the road. Or it's not gonna be in the way. Alright, let's go, buddy. Yeah, he's gonna need a refueling for the final journey to the mill. That's it. Get onto the road where you'll actually get lots of traction. Second gear. Yeah, we don't wanna go too fast here. We're just trying to pull up. For the refuel. There we go. Oh, whoa, bear. Okay. That's good. That's good enough for me. So bring him up. Because, yeah, we got lots of fuel. This is one of the actual episodes where I had to use a lot of the fuel in my backup fuel truck. Surprisingly. Alright, he's topped up. Let's move forward. He's topped up. And he's topped up. So if we need this truck, we're just gonna, you know, we'll pull him up here off to the side. Yes, of course, you're gonna open for this. Why not? It doesn't have logs. Alright. That looks like a good distance. Now here comes the fun part. We're gonna have to drive through here and either go around or go straight through. One of the two. That's all I know. We're gonna have to cut this corner on a fairly kinda wide angle. Not too much though, I don't think. Problem here. Yeah, just slow and steady into that. Whoa. Get up there. Okay. I think if I'm careful here, I can cut through. It's gonna be crazy if I do this, but hey, crazy's my motto when I play games. Let's do. Oh, come on. Squeeze your big old butt through there. Oh yeah, we're doing it. Think thin. Nice. Okay. So we got these trucks this far. And that works excellent. Save like a lot of time with that one. We just gotta follow this road up to about, I guess. I don't know. We'll see. Just go. Because if we get this done quick enough, we'll start the next map for sure. Like, definitely. So we're gonna try and do this in auto. See if it helps. I would say that, yeah, let's just cross there, but yeah, that doesn't seem like the best of ideas. Yeah, that's it, buddy. Follow the leader. Just need to get around this corner. Doesn't want to seem to go any faster here. But I'll leave it in auto just so we can save time when we can. And this is crazy. Gotta put a lot of faith in that AI driver back there. Definitely. The truck's almost just following the road itself for the most part. Whoops. That's okay. Oh, what's going on back there? Okay, that trailer looks like it's starting to level out. That made me worry just a little bit there. But yeah, we're definitely just gonna follow the road out. Definitely not gonna try and cut through the bush here with this. And this is gonna be quite the tight little turn too. Here we go. Yeah, just drive right through there, beast. And pull your buddy through too. So I don't know what's happening back there. I can't see with all the damn trees in my way. Alright. Yes, let's get out of there. Perfect. Okay. So we're right on track towards the lumber mill. And then we just gotta take a right when we get there. And we'll be there. No problem. Alright, friend. Don't go too fast because you're pretty close behind me. And we don't need to topple these trucks. Here we go, off-roading again. Let's just put it in one low so we can get through here. Okie dokie. It's not bad. This road's not bad at all. It's doable. We're almost there. Yeah. Ooh, that's a bit of an incline there. I like the way that was tipping there. But I think we got it around the corner. Let's just do this first. Alright, he's detached? No, he's not detached. I thought he was detached, damn it. Alright, park him there. No, of course not, we can't reach it. Alright, buddy. Drive you on in here. Oh, we just need that first little bit. There we go. We beat downhill. So, 3 hours, 26 minutes. Got everything done that we needed to do. So we're gonna do Deluge. I've never beat this one on hardcore, as you guys can see. These all got red stars, which means they've been beaten on hardcore. And, you know, there's different stars for different ratings. Like, I one-starred that one. That was difficult. But, yeah. So, Deluge. 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 I don't know how you say that. But whatever. So, no screwing around. This map is, quite the toughie. I'm thinking I'm gonna go with the trusty old D535 on this one. I'm gonna take maybe a C255, I don't know. I'm thinking this, but we might not need to do a whole lot of scouting if we have a D535, right? So, if anything, we might need a truck for fuel or something. But we definitely need a crane truck regardless, so that's why we're gonna bring that. Alright. Let's do this. We still have a good bit of time for this episode. Oh, look at how nice. That's actually a good thing that they stuck that on this one. Because then I believe there's two ways you could go about this. You can go down through here, which is what I'm going to attempt. Or you could try this madness also. Either way, it's all madness. There's a giant river running through the middle of the map. As you can see, everything's almost flooded. So you can either go that way, right, and try and get these vehicles. Or you can go this way and make your way up to the garage. That's the garage, yeah. It's the only garage, I think, on the map. So that's why this is literally one of the hardest maps. It's all flooded out. There's, like, you know, not really a lot of options. You gotta be very, very careful on the routes you take and how you take them. So, you know, we're gonna scout out at least that one watch point. We're not gonna get a whole lot of them done. Oops. But we're just gonna scout out the ones we need to until, you know, we decide to scout out the rest. Oh, heaven forbid. Thank you. Was that so hard? Whoops. Okay, seriously, get in gear. Crazy thing. Sorry about that transition, everyone. I had to cough there. Like I said, it's getting real cold here, and, you know, didn't want to shatter your eardrums with my crazy cough. Now, let's see. We gotta go up here. Like I said, we're gonna scout this watch point so we can at least, you know, have a better view of the river. Or we could just go mental on it and try and cross it regardless. I don't know. We'll see how it plays out. But either way, we gotta take this truck with that there, cross the river, and up to the garage ASAP. That's the primary goal first here. So scouting out the watch point is part of that goal. We're gonna try and conserve our fuel too, also, because, like, it's a big gamble, you know, using this thing. It's a big pig on fuel, but it's very reliable as far as vanilla vehicles go in Spin Tires Mud Runner. So yeah, we're gonna give it a go with this and see what happens. As you guys seen just a few moments ago, I've never been in this map on hardcore yet, so this is gonna be fun. If I'm not mistaken, from doing this on casual, there's another 8x8 located on this map once you get the watch point and you unlock it. Or you can just go scout it out yourself, either way. It's there. I think it's the other one. I don't know the name of it there, but it's the other 8x8. It's a lot more better than this one, I think. I think both 8x8s are pretty good, but you know, if you're gonna compare just those two, the other one's better for sure. There's no doubt about it. Okay. So we wanna get that watch point somehow. Looks like there's a... Which general direction is it? It's right over there. Okay. So it looks like there's a little road here. I'm gonna follow this little road. Whoops. Not drive up a damn tree. Follow the road. Crazy thing. Okay, we're gonna get up this hill, detach the trailer, and go get that watch point real quick. Unless it's like just literally over the hill, then that's cool too. But you know, it might just be better if we go without the trailer. Let's just crawl down here. Whoa. Steady there, trailer. That's it. So it's literally over there. Guess we could just tour on over there. Why the hell not? I like pulling things around through swamps. Oh, man. Alright. Where is this thing? It is that way. Can't see it. Oh! Damn, that's a tough tree. Touche, Mr. Tree. Touche. Alright. Oh, I see it. It's over there. Let's take a turn here. Yeah, it's just bombing around, you know. Like I said, this is a gamble for sure. But this will help us get a better idea on where to cross over here. Alright. Come to Papa. Okay, so we're gonna get back over here. Then we'll be able to see all the depth markers here. And I have a generally good idea where to cross. And hopefully it'll be okay. No guarantees with Mudrunner. Literally. Alright. Good enough. And away we go. Off to explore more of the map. Cross the river. Get to a garage, hopefully, before the end of the episode. All without screwing up. This is gonna be a fun challenge all on its own. Just part of the map, though. Like I said, which makes it, like, literally one of the hardest. Some people think it's impossible to cross over here, but I don't. I think it's possible. And we're gonna see if we can prove that in this episode. There we go, we're getting some speed now. Watch out for that tree, you'll get another 3 damage. Trailer just bouncing over everything. Bounce, bounce, bounce. Oh my god. Why, Mr. Tree? Why do you torture me so? Yeah, I got a new game, guys. It was on sale. It was usually $12, but I got it on sale for $1.92. It's I Am Bread. I figure that game I can, you know, vent my frustrations and stuff when I screw up, because that game is very frustrating from what I've seen about it. So that's gonna be fun. I'm gonna do a playlist on that. See, you know, if I can beat the game and how long, how many episodes it takes. I think it's gonna be awesome. Alright. We're just gonna sit right here for a moment. See, now we got a better idea. Kind of like, you know, you gotta take a risk right here regardless to get to this island, it seems. You can just cross, you know, go down. So this is the first stop. And then it looks shallow there. So I'm assuming maybe we can do something and then we're gonna have to figure out from there. Alright. Let's do this. All or nothing. All or nothing. That's what I say. Hee hee. We're going swimming. Get your floaties. Literally. Get your floaty device, people. We are going swimming. Oh yeah. Alright, kind of go with the river, but not with the river. We kind of need its help, but we don't want its help. Yeah, that thing is just gonna do whatever it's gonna do. That's all I know. Oh, well, we missed the first one, but that's okay. If we can make it to this little aisle right here. Oh, my good lord. This is mental. We can do this, though. Come on, D535. Have faith. Yes. Okay, can we just... Yeah. This is a good spot. Alright. Now we got an even better idea of what we're looking at. So yeah, it goes fairly deep. It almost seems like you gotta try and cross there, but yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna have to try and like go up that way, I guess. Is that even possible? Let's see. Let's see if the impossible is possible. Which I know it is possible. Wish they wouldn't have put a damn road there and tempted me to cross here. That's what I say. I have faith in you, truck. Don't let me down. Well, that's nice. Look at the way that thing's going. That's it. See, it's possible. It's very possible. Oh my good lord, what's going on back there? Okay, yeah, this is very possible. That's easy breezy. That's squeezy. Perfect. Let's get out of that. Conserve our fuel now. So we gotta make our journey up to the garage. If we have to, I think there's a fuel station on the way. Pretty sure. I'll double check the map, but pretty sure there is. How's that thing doing? Good. Being pulled through there just fine. Seems like it. Hey, crawl up there. I know you can. Don't tell me you can't, damn it. It's a little turtle, but it does it. Does the job. Alright. Kinda whoa, real soft there. Yeah, real soft. Okay. Let's get that watch point if we can. Take another gamble here. kind of got to go this way. We're just going everywhere with this thing, you know, like, we really shouldn't be, but we are. That's why I say it's quite a gamble. I can say there's no way you're getting up that second with a trailer. What is that? That water over there? Is that like a bay or something? I can't even see. So it wouldn't even matter. Let's just go for it. Oh, figures. Sure. That works. Weird as that was. It works. Oh no, we're gonna hit that up. We just missed it. Can we get through here? This is just crazy what I'm trying to do right now. You should not do this. Should not do this at all. But we are doing it, so it's not impossible, right? It's just something you should do. Alright, there's the watch point. We didn't burn that much extra, like, fuel, you know, doing this. So it was well worth it. Let's just rip our way up this hill. And yeah. Okay, come on. You gotta get up that hill in a reasonable amount of time. We still got a garage to unlock, got it. Alright, what do we have? We have a whole lot of log kiosk. That's what we have. Pretty sure there's a way out of here now. We can always just go back the way we came. That works too. Just have to do a crazy turnaround. Literally. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna turn around like this. Yeah, wall right off that little mountain, a little bit of a cliff, mountainside, whatever. And then go back around like this. As much as necessary, at least. Then we just gotta carefully turn. And we should be able to clear this. Yeah, perfect. Alright, back through we go. Yeah, we'll just rip on up to the... Ooh. To the garage. Wherever the road's at. Roads should be out just right there. A little hard to see. Kind of blends in with everything. We just tore all that up. Alright. This way. Come on. Because we still gotta get our crane truck over here, which is gonna be... That's gonna be fun to do in the next episode. That's all I can say. Yeah, there's a fuel station. So we just gotta have faith that we'll make it there. Cause yeah, this is gonna be fun. It's always interesting to take a gamble in this game, but it really sucks when the gamble, you know, backfires on you, and it's like, oh, crap. That's just the worst part of it. Alrighty. Well, if you can rip through there in second, that would be... I don't know if that'd be good or bad. Not really sure. Just for the simple fact that it's almost burning like 30 to 40 liters a minute there. Alright, beast. Crawl on through there. There's no problem pulling that trailer, which is great. Oh, this way again. Yeah. So this is not a bad little road so far. Oh god, this is gonna slow me right down. It doesn't seem to be. We're almost at 100 liters of fuel, but we should be making good progress. We're actually going at a good pace. We got an automatic to try and conserve fuel. We're just ripping along here. Oh my good god, what was that? What did I just hit? Clearly it's not a tree branch. Tree branch just got smushed. Alright. I think I should just keep going that way. But I really need fuel. Can we just drive straight up to the fuel? Pretty awesome. You know what? Detach the trailer. Like I said, this is gonna be quite the gamble. So I'd rather go refuel this truck and come back and finish that. Taking in that garage trailer where it needed to go. Alright, beastie. Where are we going? Come on, compass, guide me. This is going to suck. I'm down to like 60-something liters of fuel here. Oh, please tell me that's the fuel station road right there. That'd be awesome. And it is, I think. Yes, yes it is. Sweet. Alright, now we can go back, get our trailer, and finish. No worries. Thank you. Yeah, that was a bit of a close call. Like I said, a gamble. Paid off. Definitely paid off. Alright. We gotta go back, get the trailer, and continue onwards. Can't keep reversing. Alright, let's go. And yeah, it's soft mud here. How did I get through this so fast? And then now it's like... I don't know. I don't know what it's doing here. It's being finicky. Oh, there we go. Now we got second gear. Oh, third gear. Gotta be careful not to break the truck. Yeehaw! Whoa. little bear. Yeah, that's right, birds. Bugger off. Need that to get close enough. That's it. Slowly, little by little. Aw, so close. There we go. Let's get the show on the road again. The trailer's just trying to flip over and do crazy stuff. So yeah, like I said, a bit of a gamble, but it all paid off, if you say so. And yeah, all I needed was just a little bit of a couple days break from Mudrunner after that whole trailer bullcrap. Or not, that's down. Downhill there. Man, that hill's tough, that's all I can say. It's gonna take some practice. Now if I follow this road, right, is it going to take me to the garage? That's my beliefs here. Let's hope so. Alright. Is that the garage? Yes sir, that's our stop. Whoa. You're drifting in. Perfect. There, now we have this at our disposal. Let's, how much time do I got? I have a couple more minutes. Let's see if we can quickly run down and get that watch point. That's what I want to do. Just follow this road again. And I guess it just kind of meets up somewhere there. Then we're just gonna branch off right real quick, like, do some scouting. Before I have to call an episode. And now that we're full on fuel, too, well, almost full, should be good. And this road will help save some fuel for sure. So we're only like, we're burning under 10 liters right now, which is excellent. Alright. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. Heaven forbid. That was just not fun. We almost broke our one and only truck over here. Jesus. Gotta be a lot more careful with this thing. Oh well. Makes for good gameplay. Let's see. Where are we going? I'm hoping we find another truck over here. Considering that just happened, yeah. We really need another truck over here. And like I said, we gotta get our crane truck over here so we can put the actual crane add-on on the vehicle. What are we looking at here? Whole lot of open field. Okay, the watch point's just over there. Sweet. Hi-ho, Silver, in a way! That's a beast. Crawl over, but don't break yourself. For heaven's sakes. You're already broken enough. What is this? Ooh! It's the other ape I ate. Yes. Excellent. Oh, this is good. Why don't you have full fuel? That's madness. You have all that fuel on you and you're not full. Crazy. Okay, where is this one? God, that's not bad. We can just take them both back to the garage and we'll figure out what to do next episode. Come on, beastie. That's it. So now that we got some scouting done, I know we can take some shortcuts with these bigger trucks here. That'll save some time for sure. If it ever wants to crawl over this. Can you winch on to that guy? Perfect. Gonna have to help him turn, of course. But at least, you know, gets going. And they're both hooked up on the center, which is, that's good. I like that. I don't like it when they're offset the winch points. It makes for a harder convoy, I find. Can't really trust the AI driver as much, just because, yeah, they're gonna screw stuff up. So yeah, we can just keep ripping on back this way. Let's do that. Oh, I got a couple more minutes, guys, so like I said, we'll get these 8x8s back to the garage, and we'll figure out how we're gonna get our C-255 over here for loading logs up, because I believe we got I think the lumber mill's on the opposite side of the river. We basically got to cross over here just to, you know, have to load, find trucks, do scouting, load up, you know. It's crazy. Look at these things turtle their way through. Doesn't help that guy's damaged. It really doesn't. That's it. Crawl your way up there. I know you got a lot of fuel and all that, but... Oh, of course. Of course, a tree had to be in the way. Alright, now let's try it. Yeah, he'll give you a push if you need it. There you go, teamwork. Yep, that's what I'm talking about. Teamwork here. You pull him up over there. So I want to get them to this spot right here. Where am I? Yeah, we're almost at the garage. Right on. Full power! He's going faster than this one. That's weird. I thought he'd be slower or something. So I'm not quite sure what the difference is between these two other than add-ons. That's a big difference I noticed, but you know, other than that, like, what is the difference other than power, horsepower, torque, things like that? Alright. Here we go, we got that truck back. is all fixed up. Can I? Yes, that's what I want to do. Change truck. Gotta fix him up. He's kind of broken pretty good there. Didn't even mean to. But let's quickly figure out, before I call an episode, how we're going to do these log deliveries. Like I said, I think we gotta cross the river. Yeah, I think it's just the one mill. And you got the log kiosk, right? Got two of them there. And then I'm gonna try and cross back that way to get to the mill. So I think I'm going to do a, let's see here. Probably, where is it, damn it? Short log carriage with a short log trailer, right? And that'll be, what, that's like 6 points, so we need 8 in total. And then we have our crane truck, which we're gonna have to risk bringing across. I don't know. What do we have? Oh my god, a B66. That's not gonna be very helpful. So yeah, I think it would be best to try and bring, you know, that one across. Load him up with short logs. And yeah, that's what we'll do. It's gonna be a lot of fun, that's all I can say. So, thank you so much for watching, guys. It's been lots of fun, like I said. And then, you know, I needed that couple days break after the whole downhill challenge bullcrap there. That really frustrated me. But, you know, like I said, I'm gonna start a Let's Play on I Am Bread, you know, so I can vent all those frustrations as far as video games go. Because I think that would be the perfect game to do it. Like I said, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, hit that like button. I greatly, greatly appreciate it. Helps, you know, the channel grow. And I will see you guys in the next one. Have an amazing day out there.